From the beginning, human beings spent most of their energy trying to get enough food to stay alive. Centuries later, some genius discovered farming. It meant a new plateau of living for human beings. Now, if people could speak to each other across the ages.
What's that you're doing, friend?
Farming.
Farming? What's that?
Growing food. I grow enough to feed the whole family.
Sheesh. You must be a big man in your house.
Things didn't stand still, of course. People got more numerous, and human ingenuity found the way to a new plateau of abundance.
Yeah, what's that you got there, friend?
That's a plow.
Well, I figured that. I mean, what's that other thing?
Oh, that's a horse. Great worker. I grow so much food, why, I sell some of it.
Good. I'll bet you're a big man in your town.
In many parts of the world, food supply remained a serious problem. But in America, mechanical ingenuity pushed farming to a still higher plateau.
Hey, what's that, friend?
Horses, friend, horses. Lots of them. We call it a tractor.
Why, that thing must do the work of maybe five men.
That's the idea, friend. I'm taking on more land. Farming's growing. I'm growing.
You surely must be a big man in your county.
How do you like it, friend?
Wow.
It's a test model. Something new and bigger. From Ford.
Talk about horses.
Well, you've got to have them big. Got to have more power. Farms are getting bigger all the time. Why, farming's just plain big business nowadays.
That's what it is. But call it big business, because it's that too. And the man who makes it go, the big businessman who runs this farm with the split-second timing of an assembly line. Here he is. Here's your man. His name? It doesn't matter. He's a type you often meet. Successful, modern, progressive. He's a top man in his business. His description? 5 feet 10, 185 pounds. No, that's not a description of his size. Here's his description. Farm, 500 acres. 350 acres of cropland. Investment, $100,000 plus. Type of operation? Diversified. Livestock and cash grain. Methods? The latest in farm technology. Mechanization? As much as possible. With the most efficient machines he can buy, including self-propelled units and four tractors. Present condition of the operation? Excellent. Future prospects? Bigger and better. This plant manager knows what he's doing, knows where he wants to go, knows how to get there. Like the manager of any big operation, he has to know a great deal about a lot of things. He's not a chemist, but he knows the chemistry of soil, feeds, additives. He's not a mechanic, but his farm runs on wheels and cogs and gears, and he knows about them. He's not an accountant, but he knows how to keep the books. He watches costs above all. He's a smart manager, a practical efficiency expert. He must be efficient, because only the efficient farmers can stay in business. The efficient farmers are spreading out, taking over the less efficient. Every year, the size of the average farm increases. The trend is to fewer farms, bigger, more efficient farms. Fewer farmers, bigger, more efficient farmers. Our man is aware of the trend. He knows he'll need bigger machines, including bigger tractors, to stay in business. In 1939, it took the work of 8 men to feed 100 people in the United States. Today, the same number of men raise enough food to feed 200 people. During this same period, the output per man hour of feed grains has not only doubled, but has increased 3.5 times. All this means that fewer farmers are needed, but at the same time, our market is bigger. These fewer, more efficient farmers are much bigger farmers. They're buying 3 times the equipment that farmers bought in the past. They buy more equipment. They buy bigger, more expensive equipment. They buy more often, and they trade more frequently. Modern big farmers add up to a tremendous sales potential for you. Bigger, better equipment saves labor, saves costs. To increase efficiency, our man must have that larger tractor, and he knows it. He's a smart manager. The cold, hard figures of cost accounting are there to be read, and our man can read them clearly. Any farmer can read them. The cost of plowing, planting, and cultivating drops sharply when he goes from 2-row equipment to 4-row. The cost per acre drops further when he goes to still bigger equipment. So he'll move up to bigger equipment. He's a smart manager. He eats, sleeps, and dreams efficiency. It's the guiding yardstick in all he does. And efficient production on today's growing farms adds up to larger tractors and larger equipment. Imagine the new and additional opportunities big men like this will offer us when we have our new, bigger, and more powerful Ford tractors. Not only will we continue to sell thousands upon thousands of our present size tractors to him and his neighbors, but we also will sell additional thousands of our bigger Ford tractors and implements to these big men with their big needs. To appreciate how much this future market will mean to all of us with Ford, let's look at a few quick facts. Little more than 10 years ago, tractors with under 30 belt horsepower took nearly 68% of tractor sales in units. And tractors with over 50 belt horsepower, well, few were sold. Today, the 30 belt horsepower tractors hold less than 15% of unit sales nationally. Those between 30 and 50 take 43%, while the over 50 class takes 42%. Future trends indicate that tractors in the 30 to 50 class will continue to get a big share of the market, but the trend is to the larger class. How much its share of the market increases will depend upon location and type of agriculture. These are impressive facts, but even more important is this. The big tractor units will account for a much larger percent of dollar volume. That means more dollars for you. Yes, there are big prospects for big growth, new fields to conquer. Here's the man who is opening new vistas for us. Here's your added new market. He's the modern breed of farmer, the breed that will inherit the land. Take a good look at him because he's the face of future farming, and our future is tied to his. He's made it clear what he wants. He's made it clear what he's going to buy. If we're going to move up and forward with him, we've got to develop the product he's asking for. Are we doing it? Yes. We're developing the big tractor he needs and wants. Ford's new large agricultural tractor is well along in design and engineering. It's the Ford 6000 series, the Big Brute. Test models are running and working. Here is an example of what the 6000 will do. Power, big power, to do the job in a big, cost-cutting way. Everything this deer will do, everything this international harvester will do, everything they ever dreamed of doing, the new 6000 will do, and then some, with better utilization of power than ever before. The trend is to big power. More and more farmers are asking for it. More and more have said they're going to buy it. Well, it's on its way. You'll be able to sell the power to pull a really big disc. The power to pull a full five-bottom plow. The power to pull a five-bottom middle buster. You can sell power to spare, and you will be selling to a man in the big league who understands that language. Ford's 6000 series will be fitted to the times, built for the needs of growing farms, designed for a market that will grow and grow. We're talking about a large agricultural tractor, but we're getting more than that. We're also getting a big industrial tractor that will load bigger and dig bigger than we've ever done before. And the Ford 6000 is conceived big for the big world of big farm and industrial business. Big power in a big tractor to do the job in a big way. Features? The 6000 will match everything that competition can put in the field and then go on from there. Weight? 38-inch wheels, straight through axle. We're selling to a man who wants a lot of things along with power. He wants economy, efficiency, convenience. End to end, the 6000 series is designed to give our man everything he wants. It will have all the superb features that have made Ford a byword in the farm tractor field, plus an array of features never seen on a tractor before. Features that competition cannot match. The big farmer can name what he wants in a big tractor. The Ford 6000 series will have it. He can name what he wants done. The Ford 6000 will do it. The future of farming is a future of growth. Today, the American farmer produces food for 170 million Americans. In a mere 15 years, he'll have to feed 240 million Americans. To do the job economically, the farmer needs bigger, better equipment, more power, more efficient power, and he knows it. Yes, there will be new and greater opportunities for those dealers who will get ready now to sell in the big new market. We're moving into a big league, so we have to think big. We'll be selling to a man who thinks big. It takes a lot of planning, a lot of preparation to move into his league. So we're getting ready. Ford is investing more than $20 million in research, in engineering, in plant expansion. We're confident the investment will pay off handsomely for everyone who moves into the exciting future of the Ford 6000 series tractor. We're starting well ahead of time, so we'll all have time to get ready with what it takes. Everyone has a lot to do. We do not propose to compete with Deere and International Harvester in numbers of dealers. We're depending on quality operation, not quantity operation. Our dealers will continue to have a better opportunity than competition. It's a big responsibility, however, and he'll have to plan up to it. He'll have to get better capital, train more and better salesmen, arrange improved parts and service. We're in a big dollar league, selling to men who are used to spending big money for tractors and equipment essential to their big business operation. This type of farmer makes a big deal. When he comes in for a tractor, he also wants the implements to match the tractor. And he trades in a good piece of equipment. It takes capital to deal with him. Dealers will have to hire and train more salesmen. Service parts for tractors alone will be increased 45%. There will also be a sizable increase in implement parts. This, in turn, will require more space and a larger investment in parts inventory. Service tool requirements will be greater. There's need for larger service shop area, more service stalls. Prompt, efficient service will be more important than ever, so servicemen must be well selected and well trained. These are the demands of the customer, the demands of the opportunity, the demands of the market. Successful farmers are getting big because they think big. We have to match their ambition. We must think with them, grow with them, prepare ourselves to seize the coming opportunity. Deep in the heart of every man is the dream of getting into a business with big size, with scope, with growth potential, with opportunity. The chance to realize that dream will come into our hands with the Ford 6000 series. But it will take hard work to bring about the reality. The man who will buy the Ford 6000 is a smart, successful professional. He's at the top of his field. the sales and managerial abilities of our dealers are called upon to keep pace with this customer, to upgrade the dealership, to develop a new and higher level of management. The job calls for effort, planning, imagination. The rewards will be big as we lift with the swell of the times and the surge of the market. As we grow with Ford, we will reap those rewards. A bigger business, more scope, greater prestige, a position of increased leadership in the community. Our business horizons are expanding with the giant strides of the big business farmer we're measuring up to. We can have new size and scope, a dimension opened by the man whose progress we're matching. We can have growth to match his because we're entering this tremendous new market that we've never touched before. It's a time of decision. We have the market. He'll be ready to buy. He'll be willing to buy. He'll be able to buy. We're joining the biggest league in the business. Let's get ready to deal with big men and big machines.